Hello and welcome back everyone to Clash Royale video. Today I have an interesting deck. It's basically Giant Skeleton and Sparky. They're not used much, but it's off meta, it's fun. And I got to 5200 plus. So it's decent, okay? I won't say it's the best, but it's definitely one of the more fun decks you can use right now. So I want to share one this one, and then I'll share one loss, and then one the final one, basically, which helped me reach 5200. So yeah, basically I just stopped one push with Sparky. Actually, the fun part comes in overtime, but okay, we can watch the entire thing. Okay, so he starts BMing me in the middle of the match, and okay, just see for yourself, it's fun that way. Anyways, good defense on his part. We have an Elixir lead. Okay, so probably he'll use the Musketeer in the back or something, I'm not sure. Okay, no, Fireball. Pretty decent. He didn't have anything right now, which gave us the early lead, but I mess up real bad, you'll see. I use the tornado here, I guess. Basically, the idea was that the same thing, that the dead damage from Ice Golem will help me, you know, activate the King Tar. He really underestimated me this match, I'm just gonna say that. Anyway, so we're gonna go with the Giant Skeleton. The Sparky is not gonna do anything much, so that's fine. I try to get the Musketeer. If my Giant Skeleton had a little bit more health, I would have succeeded, but obviously it did not work that way. What a surprise, am I right? Anyways, this is where he starts BMing. Okay, I do BM in the match, I'm sorry about that, but he had it coming, let's just say that. And I don't feel bad for BMing, so there's that. Anyways, he's gonna mess up somewhere down the line real soon. I'm just not sure when. I'm guessing it's an overtime. So anyways, the fireballs are pretty deadly, and you can tell that I'm not going to be able to push through, let's be honest. I wouldn't have been able to push through, it's just that I got real lucky with that one push. I guess this one's it, I'm really not sure. And this was amazing, basically I managed to take down the Musketeer and lower the health on the Hog Rider. So that was an amazing game mechanic, which I didn't know about. Anyway, amazing defense on his part, so it is what it is. Now at this point I try to pull everything to the middle just to mitigate damage. Okay, I'm sorry. Yeah. So at this point he knows that he's got this one in the bag, he just needs to fireball. But he will not do that. I thought that maybe his star is low, so he'll do it now, but even then he does not. And this is where the mistake is made by him. He's gonna go with the Musketeer, and I'm gonna pull everything in the middle, and there's nothing you can do about it. And the fun part is, I loved it, simply because I made a comeback from the BM. Anyways, one loss, I think. Which was a fun one, I'm not sure. This one I recorded yesterday. No, played yesterday, didn't record it. Or did I play it today? I just played a lot of matches today. Could be today's, I'm not sure. We're gonna watch this one. I think I played this today. Yes, I did play this today. I just remember losing to those piglets, royal hogs. So there's that. Okay, it was going well in the beginning, let's just say that. Seriously, if you're just looking for a deck to trophy push, I will not recommend this. Or maybe I'll recommend it if you have like your cards at a decent level. But if you're just trying to have fun at the game, try this deck. It's amazing, okay? And I'm guessing the deck can be good because I basically lost to maxed out players. So I think it works out pretty well, especially in 2v2 and tournaments. I don't know why it lagged, I'm sorry. We're gonna go with Sparky, hopefully. I'm loving the Sparky, it's amazing. Yes, so now his mirror Royal Hogs are a bit annoying. At this point, I was pretty happy because my tower health was over 2k and my King Tower was ac also activated. So everything was going well right now. And things started going south in the right lane. You'll see. It's gonna come pretty soon. I was hoping that my giant Skelly will reach the tower, but it did not. Very well played on the archers to him though, so there's that. Right now, I'm gonna go with the Hunter, and I think just when I placed on the Sparky, he's gonna go with the Royal Hogs. Yep. And I'm gonna mirror this. Sorry, tornado it. The tornado worked out pretty well, but I think the Skeleton Dragon nerf is a bit excessive. Or maybe because it's a 4-level difference. So there's that as well. I really need to start upgrading these cards. Now, sadly, the Sparky died to Tesla, and Hidden Tesla is actually pretty amazing right now. I think they fixed up that thing like where the Earthquake is able to damage the Hidden Tesla, and Earthquake is the only one that can do so. I tried to pull the Royal Hogs, but I just couldn't do it. I only got two. So, decent match. Nothing too bad or nothing too special. Now, this is the last match for today. Yeah, so I got the early activation, which was amazing. Definitely, always good. Then, hopefully, Sparky or these guys, Goblin Barrel. I'm pretty sure you're familiar with the name, but it's really unprofessional of me to just say that guy and all that stuff. Anyways, mirror on both of them. Zap on one, mirror on the other. You get what I'm saying. I'm very tired when I record this video, which is not an excuse, but hey, give me a break at least. Sorry. Really unprofessional of me. Anyways, getting back in the match, we're gonna go with Goblin Barrel, yes. This combo used to be the best in the early days. And by the early days, I mean when I was in a lower arena because no one could counter it. I used to watch those old Clash YouTubers back in the day. Some of them even discontinued their channels, which is pretty sad. And yeah, so I got the idea of Giant Skeleton and Goblin Barrel from them back in the day. So I used to play that. Found a lot of success in it. And basically, just when I unlocked Lava Hound, Lava Hound used to be the best. I think Lava Hound is still the best legendary. Simply because, here's the thing, right? The thing that made Lava Hound so special for me was that the Lava Hound players were always lower leveled in higher arenas. So basically, that's basically the mark of either the player is too skilled or the Lava Hound is just too good for pushing. And I went with the latter simply because, I'll be honest, it was easy to push with the lava, huh? That's just a fact. Anyways, I deviated a bit off topic there, but yeah. You can see why I like the Lava Hound. It was also my first legendary, and I got it after a long time. Like, these days, unlocking a legendary is not that difficult, I'd say, but still a decent difficulty, but yeah. It's not nearly as difficult as it used to be. Like, getting that legendary chest, and there was a chest cycle, there still is. And if the chest was in, like, the later stages of the cycle, you can forget about it. I literally almost finished the game. Finish the game basically means reaching the ultimate legendary arena, which used to be the Royal Arena, I think. Yeah, so yeah, that's about it. And wow, the story and the match both ended. What a surprise. Anyways, if you guys did enjoy, please do leave a like and subscribe. It really helps me a lot. The deck is fun. Be sure to check it out. Here it is. I'm gonna upgrade this. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. Peace out.